good shot again. On time.
Jesus, your name is God. Jesus, your name is God. Great is your name.
told us that when we confess our sins, you are faithful and just to forgive us our sins. Please accept our confession and forgive us. We thank you, we love you, and we praise your name. Amen.
Amen.
Yeah.
Put aside the cares of life and the busyness of living. We're hurrying about, planning, preparing, fixing, organizing, and yeah, worrying about how everything's going to turn out. Even while we're here in church, those thoughts tend to drown out your voice and what you want to say to us. We do want to hear from you and renew our faith that you're there and that you know us where we are in our walk with you. Help us to be sensitive to your needs, the needs of our brothers and sisters. And speak a word of encouragement or comfort, or give a sincere smile or a handshake. We do care about each other, and we want to show it. We ask for each one on the prayer list, Lord. Help us to speak their name in our prayers to you each day. Hear our prayers for those whose lives have touched us, those who are in pain, those who are ill, those who grieve. May we touch their lives not only through our prayers, but through our lives and actions as well. Lord, we live in a dangerous and uncertain world. Each day the news is filled with reports that give us uneasy. Yes, I'm afraid it's fear too. We know, Lord, that you're in control and we praise you for your greatness. For we know that when we belong to you, we have assurance that you will take care of your own. Father, we ask for the leaders of our nation today, whatever capacity they hold, touch their hearts to seek your wisdom as they face each day. We ask for the personnel, the military personnel, stationed around the world. We know they face dangers and the possibility of death day after day. Guide and direct them as they serve. Hold them in your hand. We pray for our church that it will grow and reach out to the unsaved. Give us courage, strength, and determination as we walk with you throughout our days. We want to be your hands and feet in all areas of our lives so that others see Jesus in you. Guide us, Lord. Bless us, hold us, and hold us. For we are your children, called to your purpose in your work. Hear our prayers, those spoken and those hidden in our hearts. We pray in the name of Christ, who taught us to pray, saying,
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation,
The very first chapter of Zacharias and Elizabeth, being told they were going to have a son in their old age, and they would call him John. That's the story of John the Baptist. Also in Luke, we read the story of the Virgin Mary being visited by Angel Gabriel, that she's going to have God's son, and she's the name of Jesus. So, you know, Jesus' name would be, they were important to him. So if God was careful with names, you and I should be too, right? And God's name should be the most important name we'll use. Never to use it irreverently or in vain or lightly. I'm afraid our world does that too much today. God has many names that reveal his identity. And all these names tell us who he is. There's Jehovah, Emmanuel, Everlasting God, Heavenly Father, the Great I Am, and we could just sit here for a long time telling all his names. So what I want to talk about right now is he's the Promise Keeper. You know, God doesn't break his promises, ever. You can believe them, rely on them, trust them to be kept forever. The book of Hebrews tells us that it is impossible for God to lie. Isn't that good enough? You can trust God's promises, that they're true and everlasting. A favorite verse of mine is John 3:16. Maybe it's one of your favorites. The New International Version reads like this: For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal life. And when I memorized this verse as a child, it was from the King James, because that's all we had. Tells you how old I am. And it read like this: For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believed in him should not perish but have everlasting life. No other verse in the Bible clearly summarizes God's relationship with us humans and the way of salvation. Lots of folks consider John 3:16 to be the theme verse of the entire Bible. It tells us of the love God has for us and the extent of that love, so great that he sacrificed his only Son on our behalf. It teaches us that anyone who believes in Jesus Christ, God's Son, will be saved and gives us the glorious hope of eternal life in heaven. Now that word believes means more than intellectual awareness or knowledge or belief that Jesus is God's Son. It means to rely on him, to trust him, and to cling to him. Whosoever or whoever or anyone is all inclusive. No one, absolutely no one, is left out. 1 Timothy 2:4 reads like this: God our Savior wants all people to be saved and to come to the knowledge of the truth. I'd like us to try something. You will find in your bulletin at the top of the page the words to John 3:16. I'd like us all to read it together.
Son, that whoever believes in him
promise of eternal life with him because you're one of his own. John 10:3 says he calls his own sheep by name. That's very comforting to me. And then over in Revelation 3:5 it says, all who are victorious, and that means believers, will be clothed in white, and I will never erase their names from the book of life, but I will announce them before my Father and his angels that they are mine. Will your name be found in the book of life? Names are important to God. You can put your trust in God, believe and rely on his promise. Just say yourself, God said it, I believe it. That settles it. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
We're going to sing a song called When the Road is Called Around. You may not know this. But it says just what we've been talking about today. And so I'd like to start. We're going to learn if you don't know what we're going to learn. Okay? So let's stand up. Yeah, stand up. Sing this song. Upon you.